Let's look at an example of finding probabilities, the median, and the cumulative distribution function for a continuous probability distribution. This does require calculus, and I'm going to assume that you are familiar with basic integration techniques. Suppose for a random variable x, the probability density function f of x is equal to c times x cubed when x is between 2 and 4, and 0 otherwise. C is just some constant. What value of c makes this a legitimate probability distribution? In order for this to be a legitimate probability distribution, two conditions must be satisfied. First, it can never take on negative values. And here, we have c times x cubed between 2 and 4, and so x cubed only takes on positive values there, so we know that c cannot be negative, otherwise f of x would be negative sometimes, and that's simply not allowed. The second condition is that the area under the entire curve must equal 1. So the integral from minus infinity to infinity of f of x dx must equal 1. Here, the integral of c times x cubed dx has to equal 1. But we're not going to integrate this from minus infinity to infinity because this is only the PDF between 2 and 4. Outside of there, it's 0. So we're simply going to integrate this between 2 and 4. The integral from 2 to 4 of c times x cubed dx is equal to c times the integral from 2 to 4 of x cubed dx. And if we carry out that integration, we're just going to get c times x to the fourth power over 4 evaluated at 2 and 4. And so this is going to be equal to c times 4 to the fourth power over 4 minus 2 to the fourth power over 4. This is equal to 60 times c. And we know that 60 times c must equal 1 because the area under the entire curve has to equal 1. So 60 times c is equal to 1, and this of course implies that c is equal to 1 over 60. This is the constant that makes this a legitimate probability distribution. Here's the probability density function plotted out. This curve is 1 over 60 times x cubed between 2 and 4, and then it drops to 0 outside of there. So f of x is 0 outside of the interval 2 to 4. And we chose that constant 1 over 60 to ensure that the entire area under that curve is equal to 1. Suppose we want to find the probability the random variable x takes on a value greater than 3. For continuous probability distributions, probabilities are simply areas under the curve. So the probability the random variable x takes on a value greater than 3 is simply the area under the curve to the right of 3, and that's what we're looking for, and that's what we need to find. And we can find that area using integration. To find the probability the random variable x takes on a value greater than 3, first note that the probability density function drops to 0 beyond 4, so the random variable x cannot take on values greater than 4. So we are going to integrate from 3 to 4, 1 over 60 times x cubed dx. We're integrating our probability density function from 3 to 4. This is equal to 1 over 60 times x to the fourth power over 4. When we integrate x cubed, we get x to the fourth over 4, and that's evaluated between 3 and 4. And so this is 1 over 60 times 4 to the fourth over 4 minus 3 to the fourth power over 4. And this works out to 175 over 240, which is approximately 0.729. And back to the plot of the PDF, when we integrated that function, we found that that area is approximately 0.729. Visually, that's what we just found. What is the median of this distribution? The median is the value of the variable that splits the area into halves, where we have 0.5 over here and 0.5 over here. This is the median, and I'm going to call that value m. To find m, we would note that the area to the left of m is a half, and so the integral from minus infinity to m of f of x dx, that's got to equal 1/2. Note again that f of x is 0 for values of x less than 2. So when we're finding the median, we're going to integrate from 2 to m of this, 1 over 60 times x cubed dx. The integral from minus infinity to 2 is 0. And we need this to be equal to 1/2. The integral from 2 to m of 1 over 60 x cubed dx is equal to, well, what the heck, we'll throw in one more step, 1 over 60 integral 2 to m of x cubed dx, and this is equal to 1 over 60 times, we're integrating x cubed, and we're going to get x to the fourth power over 4. And we're evaluating that between 2 and m. And so this is equal to 1 over 60 times m to the fourth power over 4 minus 2 to the fourth power over 4. And this works out to m to the fourth power minus 2 to the fourth power over 240. And we know that must equal 1/2. And if we use a little algebra, we'd see that this implies that m to the fourth power is equal to 136, multiplying by 240, bringing the 2 to the fourth over. And so then we know that m is equal to the fourth root of 136, and that is approximately 3.415. Visually, what we just found is this median is approximately 3.415. Suppose we want to find the cumulative distribution function for the random variable x. Capital F of x is equal to the probability the random variable x takes on a value less than or equal to little x. And this is going to be equal to the integral from minus infinity to x of f of t dt, introducing the dummy variable t here because x is one of our limits of integration. But again, the PDF is 0 for values of x less than 2, and so this is simply going to be the integral from 2 to x of 1 over 60 t cubed dt, our dummy variable introduced into our PDF. This is equal to 1 over 60 times t to the fourth power over 4, evaluated between 2 and x. And so this is 1 over 60 times x to the fourth power over 4 minus 2 to the fourth power over 4. Simplifying a little bit, we get that our f of x, our cumulative distribution function, is equal to x to the fourth minus 2 to the fourth over 240. This is true for values of x that lie between 2 and 4. Outside of that interval of values, we have to think about it a little bit. The cumulative distribution function is the probability the random variable x takes on a value less than or equal to little x. So f of x is going to be equal to 0 when x is less than 2, because the random variable x can't take on values less than 2. And f of x is going to equal 1 when x is greater than 4 because the random variable x must take on a value less than or equal to 4. And we can use this cumulative distribution function to help us find probabilities. What is the probability the random variable x takes on a value less than or equal to 2.7? Well, we could carry out the integration again, but we could also remember that our f of x, our cumulative distribution function, is equal to the probability that the random variable x takes on a value less than or equal to little x. And we just worked this out using integration to be x to the fourth power minus 2 to the fourth power over 240. And so if we want the probability the random variable x takes on a value less than or equal to 2.7, this is just the cumulative distribution function evaluated at 2.7. And that's simply going to be 2.7 to the fourth power minus 2 to the fourth, or 16, over 240. And this is approximately 0.155. If we have a cumulative distribution function that is of closed form like this, then it can really help us find probabilities, because we only have to carry out that integration once to get the cumulative distribution function, and then we can simply put values into that function to get probabilities. Although conceptually the same thing is going on for any continuous probability distribution, not all continuous probability distributions have nice closed-form solutions for the cumulative distribution function, and sometimes it must be found by integrating the PDF numerically.